Hare Krishna. Bhagavad Gita is not a religious book. Yes, it is followed by many Hindus. It's a success manual for life. It can be used by Hindus, Christians, Muslims, Buddhists, atheists alike. Today we will discuss the principles which Bhagavad Gita lays out to become rich. We need money in the world to live. Not too much of it. We need just sufficient so that we can live a comfortable life. This is 6th chapter, 41st sloka. Prapya punya krutan lokan ushitva sasvatai samaya suchinam srimatam gehe yoga brashto abhijayate. The unsuccessful yogi, after many, many years of enjoyment on the planets of the pious living entities, is born into a family of righteous people or into a family of rich aristocracy. Actually, Krishna, Lord Krishna, here he is referring to reincarnation. He is saying that some people are born into rich families and some people are born into pure families because of their past karma. So this is giving us a reason to be pious, to be on the right side of law at the judgment day. In case you don't want to subscribe to this reincarnation beliefs, that's okay. Even if you think it from a material point of view, for example, Mahatma Gandhi had said, find the means, find the purpose, the means will follow. Find a reason why you need money. Honestly, I mean, after some, you know, after some level of middle class level of comfort, the amount of money which you have over that, it doesn't really, really help you. It only spoils us. What we are looking for is not really money, but for happiness, ananda. So anyway, find a good reason why you need money. And then, if the reason is good enough, the inner self in you will guide you to how to get it. Don't ask for money for your own sense enjoyment. You know, maybe you will, let's say, get a lot of money and let's say you go to Hong Kong and you blow up. I mean, I have friends who have lost $1 lakh in gambling overnight. You know, you'll just vanity, you know, you'll take the money and you'll blow it up on useless purposes. We all know, you know, a lot of people who had $200 million or $1 billion and they just couldn't manage it and they ultimately ended up filing for bankruptcy. For example, Michael Jackson. One is you need to qualify for the money, you need to have a higher purpose, why you need the money, and you also need to learn how to manage the money. That is where your buddhi, di shakti, comes into picture. So, you know, it's awesome to ask for money for the sake of loka kalyanam, for the sake of good of the world. If that is what you want to do, please go ahead and ask for God for a lot of money and please go ahead and plan for it. Also, please recognize that money is not going to change the world. The quality of life which we have is much, much higher than our grandparents, and it's much, much higher than 200 years ago. But still, we have more polluted water, we have more polluted earth, because money is not the answer to the lack of human discipline. So if you still have a good purpose, go ahead, ask for a lot of money, plan for it. And the best way to use money is to serve people. We should serve people on their bodily level, at their mind level, and at their soul level. For example, we might send lots of kids to school. But in the school, kids are distracted by Sachin Tendulkar or Sridevi or Juhi Chawla or Amitabh Bachchan or your favorite actor. And they are not really focused 100% on their studies. The amount of focus which they have in the school is limited. So just sending kids to school is not enough. In addition, we need to help them have the right mind values so that whatever inputs are being in school are going in. And then we also need to help people at a spiritual level. The whole world is eating the wrong kinds of food, which is creating a lot of harm to animals, and thinking that, you know, their happiness is lying in eating this animal or that animal, And that is where my happiness is. Actually, it is short-sighted, but it will come back to us. Karma will take effect and it will come back to us. And people are eating, foods which are very, very burning to the stomach, etc., etc. And we should help people understand that in addition to sending kids to school, we should also give the right kind of foods to kids. And the best food is vegetarian, pure vegetarian. No meat, no fish, no egg. Krishna also has another sloka in Bhagavad Gita about money. That's actually the last sloka of Bhagavad Gita. I think it's spoken by Sanjaya, not Krishna. Yatra Yogeshwara Krishno, Yatra Partho Dhanudharaha, Tatra Sri Vijayo Bhutir, Dhruvan Itir Matir Mama. So, when there is Krishna, God, there is no shortage of money. Today we are all wanting money. We worship Lakshmi Devi, but we should also worship Narayan, who is the husband of Lakshmi Devi. When there is Krishna, money will flow. Find a good purpose, the money will flow. Thank you. Hare Krishna. Actually, we need to have a very pious life, and pious life is defined as chanting God's names, eating the right kinds of food, preferably only prasadam, eating only food offered to God. It purifies our intelligence, chanting God's names, and reading scriptures. And you can read scriptures like Bible or Quran or Bhagavad Gita. The amount of knowledge which is there in books like Bhagavad Gita or Srimad Bhagavatam is far higher than the amount of knowledge which is there in Bible and Quran, because these were spoken in West Asia 5,000, sometime 3,000 years ago, where practically, in the case of Bible, it is spoken to slaves, and there is so much knowledge which could be given to them. And Lord Jesus Christ himself visited India for around 12 years, and it's reasonable to believe that he got in touch with Bhagavad Gita too. So Bhagavad Gita is a success manual for life. It is not a religious book. There is no single word Hindu in Bhagavad Gita. If you do see it, please let me know. I would like to be educated. Please chant the names of God. Please read Bhagavad Gita. It will purify your consciousness. Thank you. Hare Krishna.